I am so
welcome back. If it's your first time, welcome. My name is Bethel and I have this thing on my channel called Sew with KIZAJ. It's basically a cross plan where I show you how to sew right from the basics, and this is lesson 4. I really don't know what to name this lesson because it's kind of tricky. So basically what I'm doing in this lesson is showing you how to transfer the measurements you took in the last lesson onto the pattern or to the fabric. So I think I'm going to call it how to make measurements make sense on the fabric. It's really easy. You already measured the person. That was one step. Now the next step is actually the arithmetic of sewing. How are you going to transfer all those measurements you took onto this to make it eventually a piece of clothing? So the first tip I'm going to give you is anything that's measured horizontally. I always confuse horizontally and vertically, but look at my hand motion. If I call it the wrong one, I'm so sorry. But anything that's measured sideways like this, like the bust or the hip, is going to be divided. The reason why we're dividing is if you take a piece of clothing and observe it, let's observe this shirt I'm wearing. I can see that this shirt has a stitch here, so there's a break somewhere. I can see that this shirt is like just straight, has two pieces, but there's two breaks. So that means we are going to divide it to be able to cut this out perfectly. Lengthwise, there really is no break. It's just straight down. So for the length, it's actually going to be as is. What do I mean? In this clip where I was measuring her bust, I measured it round like so. Now, if I want to cut out the piece of fabric, it's going to be folded in the middle so that way I'm dealing with less fabric and I'm having it equal on both sides. So the main reason why we fold clothes when we're sewing them is so that we have it equal on both sides. You don't want to like leave it out open and then this curve doesn't match with this curve. That's why we fold it. So if I want to cut this whole front piece, I'm going to fold it in two, just like so. Imagine this is my fabric, right? And I want to cut this shirt out of it. What I'm going to do to cut out the front piece is to fold it into two. So now that I've folded it into two, like this, this thing does not like to stay. So I'm going to use my ruler to hold it. So now that I've folded it into two, what about the back? What do you think is going to happen to the back? So I'm going to turn. There's no seam at the back. It's, you know, cut out straight too. So I'm going to fold the back into two too, but let's focus on the front. So I'm folding the front into two, like so. So one, two layers, and I'm folding the back into two, but I'm going to cut the back separate. If you want, you can fold again and layer it on top. But I just want to take note of how many layers we have. We have four layers. How many do you think you're going to have to divide your bust into? So because we have four layers, that bust measure I took last week, which was 32, I'm going to have to divide that into four for the bust. Does that make sense? So for the bust, anything that goes around the body is divided into four depending on the style. So for like a style like this that has just like a plain front, there is no middle line, there's no other line here, it's just plain, it's going to be divided into four. Now even if there was a line behind where there's like for the zip allowance or like for buttons or something, it's still going to be divided into four, but you're going to add a little more to the end whenever you cut. Does that make sense? So for example, I'm just going to cut out this piece again. If I was going to layer on top, and maybe I'm trying to make this shirt, but it has a zipper at the back, what's going to happen is this is my front. I folded my front into two. This is my back. I folded my back into two. So I'm just going to place it like so on top of each other and leave this little allowance here for the zipper. So that zipper there does not affect how many we're dividing it. It only affects if there's zipper in front too, and then maybe want to cut this part and that part, then maybe it's going to like glitch a little bit, but the zipper does not affect the fact that we're dividing it into four. Capish? Same thing with the waist, because it's round, we're dividing it into four. Same thing with the hip, because it's round, we are dividing it into four. So now the bust is 32. To divide it, your tape is super easy. All you got to do is so raising the inch part like so, right? So we're going to look for 32. Her bust was 32. So this is where 32 is, right here. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to take this part of the tape and meet 32. So the start of the tape from number one, that silver thing, I'm going to put it on 32. And this way, we have like a whole round body. This way, I've divided it into two. So if there was, say, no line on this thing, I would probably just divide it into two, or maybe like just one stitch line. I'd probably just divide it into two. Say maybe it was like a round thing and then there was like one stitch line at the back. Probably divide it into two, but you know, never happens like that. So let me not confuse you guys. We're dividing it into four. So now this is how to divide it into two. You put the one here at not one, but like, you know, zero on 32. So now this is divided into two. To divide into four, we're going to mark. So 32 divided by 2 is 16 right here. We're going to take that 0 point again and put it on 16 to give us whatever we're dividing by. So that gives us 8. Or you could just use your calculator, but trust me, this is faster. Once you're like in the spirit of sewing, this is faster. So that's how to divide with your tape. So again, I'm going to mention what is divided into 4. The bust is divided into 4. The under bust is divided into 4 because it's round the body. The waist is round the body too, so it's divided into 4. The hip is also round. The tape goes round the body, so it's divided into 4. What else is divided into 4 that I took last week? Let me give you a second to guess. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and tell you. The steps, like the round of the knee, is divided into 4. Hope that makes sense. So now let's talk about something else that's divided into like a different number. What about the shoulder? Remember last week we took the shoulder from here to here across the body like so. This was how we took the shoulder measurement. I'll show you here. So how many do you think we're going to have to divide the shoulder measurement into? Just think for a second. Okay, if you said 4, you're kind of wrong, and I'll tell you why. But if you said 2, you're right. So if I measured my shoulder like this, then very well we divide it into 4. But we only measured halfway, so here to here. Hence, that's going to make me divide it into 2 because it was only one part. We didn't go round. But if I went round and I was making like an off shoulder, I'll divide it into 4. So from here to here, that is why we're dividing into 2. Make sense? It's kind of funny, but I don't really want to show you guys like cutting it out because then you guys don't really know. Since you're beginners, you don't know what it looks like to cut. But when we start cutting, I'm going to refer back to this video. It's going to make so much more sense then. So now let's talk about length. If I was making a skirt, let me stand up. Do you like my outfit? But I was making a skirt and the skirt stops at my knee and I took the measurement like this. When I come to cut the skirt, would I need to divide it? There's no joining, it's just a straight skirt, like from here to here straight. If I come to cut it, am I supposed to add any measurement to it? It's an interactive class, even though I'm talking to a camera. But yes, Felicia, you got the answer. No, I'm not going to divide it. The reason being that there is no joining, it's just a straight skirt lengthwise. Most things are straight lengthwise. So there is no need to divide. You never need to divide lengthwise. The only thing you might need to do lengthwise is add or subtract. What do I mean? Say I'm measuring for a full dress and I measure from the shoulder to the floor, but the dress has a cut on the waist. What I'm going to do is, if I'm cutting the bottom part, I'm going to subtract the waist part and actually start from, like, you know, say I'm sewing a dress and the measurement starts from the shoulder to the floor, but it has a cut in the middle or a joining in the middle. I'm not going to divide. You never divide for length, but I'm going to subtract. What it means is, when I'm cutting, I'm going to subtract the measurement from the shoulder to the waist where that joining is going to be, and then I'm going to measure whatever value I have left. So for example, here her dress length is, say, 60 inches, and then her half length, which is where the cut starts, the half length is 15 inches. When I'm measuring for the bottom part, to cut out the bottom part of the skirt, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to start taking my measurement from 15, you know, just leaving this to pretend I still have my top part. I'm going to start the measurement from 15 and measure it downwards. I prefer to do it that way, or what you could do is actually subtract it. So 60 minus 15, I actually don't know what that is. 45. Yeah, wow, kind of smart. That is correct. But 60, or you can use a calculator and just do 60 minus 15 and then you just measure the bottom part, 45. But to be honest, it's easier to just like start the measurement from 15 and just let the rest go. Like I said, it's going to make sense when we're actually sewing things like this. So something else that we divide into two. So round arm, for example, measuring the round arm, 10. So the arm usually has just one seam. So seeing that it has just one seam, how many are we going to divide the arm into? The arm measurement is 10. What are we going to divide the arm by? Are we going to divide it by 2 or by 4? What do you think? Oh, thanks, Joanne. 2. See, I got smart student. We're going to divide it into 2. I'm cringe, I know, sorry. But we're going to divide it into 2. The reason being that it's just one stitch we have, so we don't need to match the shape to like a different part. So we're just going to divide it to 2 so we can have that line to sew on. What about your thigh? What do you think? How many do you divide your thigh into? So these are our thigh, measuring just one leg. What do you think? How many are we going to need to divide the thigh by? So you got it right. Marvelous. We're going to divide the thigh by 2 also. So now this is really tricky, but the thigh has 2 stitches. Like you can see on my pants, there's a stitch line here and there's a stitch line here, but we're still going to divide it by 2. Why? Because this stitch line here is totally different from this stitch line here. They're not the same, or they're not related. We're just making it round the leg, not round the 2 legs. So each leg is its own 2. So the body is divided into 4. So in the middle and then the sides right here. If you're measuring anything round, then you're going to have to divide it by 4. But if you're measuring like say half of that, like for example my legs now, you can already see that there's a split between my leg. So if I'm measuring my leg, it's only going to be divided into 2 because that's half of the body, which is 2. But if I'm measuring my hip, it's going to be 4 because that goes around the body. So this lesson was really, really simple if you actually understood it. I hope you did. Let me know in the comment section if there's like an easier way to explain, like if you're a pro, or if you have any specific questions about this. Like I said, I'm making this video so that in the future when I make videos on how to cut tops, I'm going to refer back to it so that, that way you can see, okay, this is why she divided this by this. This is why she divided this. This is an explanation for all the calculations that's going to take place. Ugh, see, I'm rhyming. Okay, I need to get back on track. But yeah, I'm rhyming. I need to become a rapper. Am I in the right line of work? But yeah, easy peasy. Don't overthink it. Just think of the body as divided into 4. The length is literally never divided, maybe just subtracted. And basically, that's the arithmetic of sewing. It's not hard. But then we're going to like, that's the basic of it. But once you get the basics, you're going to be able to divide anything. For example, say you have a 6-piece skirt. You're going to know how many to divide it into. I'm going to, when we get to those advanced levels, I'm going to explain, like, you know, how to divide when you have more than 1 pieces, how to divide when you have like a bust cut, how to divide when you have like bustier and stuff like that. Super easy, I promise you. But this is the basics. Let me know what you think about this video. If you have any questions, the Telegram group, it's not just me on there, there's other professionals, so they would answer you on there if you join the Telegram group and ask the questions there, or the comment section. I'll answer it as soon as I see it. But thank you so much for watching this video to this point, and I hope to see you on my next sewing tutorial video, which we're starting to sew. The next video is going to be lesson 1 of part 2, which is lesson 5 technically, but the next video is going to be lesson 5 part 2, and it's going to be how to sew a basic skirt. So we're starting to sew, and I'm so excited that we've gotten to this part of this course. But let me know what you think in the comment section. Don't forget to subscribe if you have not, and please turn on notifications so that way you do not miss any of my videos. I'll see you all next week. Bye.